What I know about prison is when someone has done something wrong, he or she will go there. When I was a little child, I was there with my mother. I used to play with my fellow children, with my mother, and it was just fine.
Women who are incarcerated, some of them go to prison with their children who are young. The law allows them to bring their children who are below 4 years to prison. But also it's possible that women can be brought to prison who are, you know, expectant, and they deliver while in prison.
I feel like staying with the mom, I feel like it will be better for them because mothers, they tend to care more about the child. They tend to know where the child is, who know what they're doing, you know. Staying with the mom will give the child even a more comfortable, like not surrounding, but like the child will be more composed, feel more comfortable.
If mothers are absent for too long, children may fail to acquire those important bonds, those strong social bonds with the society.
According to the Constitution of Kenya, Article 53, children have a right to be protected.
The Bangkok Rule 49 says children in prison with their mothers should never be treated as prisoners.
I can remember the day I was baptized. I was being baptized and the following day I went there and I decided to get inside the water. And I drowned, so they came and took me. That is the day that I remember. There I was playing with my fellow children while my mother was washing our clothes. When the day that we were told we are going to be visited with my family members, I was always just sitting and see how it's going to be that day when we are going to be visited.
We are talking about an average of about 200, 250, maximum 300 children going with their mothers to prison. If we say there's one woman having only one child in prison, so we're talking about maybe 300 women at any given time. But we also have to take note of the fact that the prisons is a very fluid system. People come in and people leave on a daily basis, depending on when their sentences have lapsed, and also depending on new people being admitted into the system. But also besides those that have already been sentenced, there are also those awaiting their sentencing, waiting adjudication. You can't talk about a very big number though, but 300 children is a big number, a significant number, because these are children who will miss opportunities for optimal brain development. And if their brains don't develop well, then we have, there's no solid foundation for their future life.
When I grow up, I would like to be a footballer because I want to be famous and to have money.
The early years, 0 to 3, what they call the first 1,000 days, is the most important window for brain development and also development of other skills. And during that time, you require a very stable environment, both socially and even in the provision of all the needs for life: food, shelter, clothing, responsive caregiving, nurturing and responsive care. And so without this, then we won't lay a very good foundation, and hence the need to have that kind of, you know, support from all quarters to make the prisons friendly to early childhood.
With children who are in prison, I would speak about those ones who are born there. They are already like in a family setup. Usually when they're in the cell, you see it's a group. They're with different people, and there is no that like family background as such. It's only that maybe if the child was with a mother, they are now attached to the mother. But you notice they don't have like a sense of belonging.
My name is Nyapia Barongo Sike and my stage name is Leila Chibale. I am 9 years old. Prison is a facility where people who have committed crimes such as stealing and murder go to so that they can't cause any more trouble.
My name is Tara Njenga. I'm 11 years old. When I grow up, I want to be a pilot because it is fun. I play PP on Zora. A very bad life. Eating raw food. I'll just be praying for her. I could just feel comfortable because I'm with my mom.
My name is Angel Pamela. I'm 9 years old. I'd like to be a fashion designer. Prison is a place where people who break the law are kept. Yes, there are children who are born in prison because some women, when they go to prison when they are pregnant. I feel bad for the children who are in prison, and I thank God for everything He has given me in my life.
My name is Ryan Mondangoro. I'm 13 years old. I'm a candidate. I know prison is an institution where criminals are detained legally for the crimes they are committed. I also know it's a rehabilitation center. Yeah, I have heard stories on Citizen. The one I've heard that's most recent and I think most common is for Langata Prison. At first I felt really bad for the kids. I felt like they didn't deserve it because it's not their fault. I feel like the children should be helped, should not be taken like your mom is a criminal, so you're also a criminal. I feel like they should still be given the right to education, like to live a normal life, to live a happy life.
There are 43 women prisons in Kenya. Of these 43, only 10 have got adequate provisions for childcare. They have daycare centers where children can be taken care of during the day by caregivers, meaning that 33 of them still lack. So over 75% lack appropriate childcare facilities. But also we found that government is doing all it can through the prisons department to provide for childcare services in prisons. So according to the prisons, each child is budgeted an allocation of 415 shillings per day and the mother 210 shillings per day. That's a budget that is there in the books, but it may not be informed by the science of the needs of children. Kenya is a member or has ratified the Convention on the Rights of the Child, the CRC of the UN. Kenya has also ratified the ACRWC, African Charter for the Rights and Welfare of the Child. And Kenya is also signatory to the Bangkok Rules. Even our constitution itself also recognizes the rights of children.
The Bangkok Rule 49 says children in prison with their mothers should never be treated as prisoners.
That day was, my mother was telling me that I'm soon going to be out from jail. So a teacher came and asked me, would you like to go to a children's home or to stay? I said I would like to go because I saw the car that was beautiful, so I decided to go. I was thinking about my mother, how she will feel while I'm not with her. So so I was worried.
The process of separation is usually very traumatizing, especially to children, because you see they are always bonded with their parents, and then you have to like detach them again. It's so mostly what happens during the initial stage, we prepare the children immediately when they get into the, before we get them, because we are called by the prison attendant, and then we have to talk to the children about it, depending on how their capacity to understand the situation. Some of them also, they were not used to that, yeah. And some of them have even born in prison. So all throughout they've been with their parents. And then they don't understand, why are you separating us? Why? Yeah, these are questions you cannot answer that child.
At the car, I wasn't feeling anything. I was just thinking how it is going to be here. So, but when I stayed for like 2 weeks, I started crying for my mother because I've missed her very much.
And what happened when you cried for her? Did someone listen to you and help you feel better? And then when did you go see your mother again?
I was being told that she's all right. I'm going to visit her.
So when you went, when did you go to, when now after you came here, you have been visiting, you went to visit your mother?
Yes.
How was it like for you going to visit her again?
The day that I was being told that I'm going to visit my mother, I felt very like I'm free because I've missed her. So the day that I went to visit my mother, even I didn't stop to listen for instructions that you are going to be given. So I ran to my mother. She told me that she was free, and I'm soon going to stay with her.
The gap there is lack of a comprehensive reintegration policy. There is no child officer designated to be handling children who are being reintegrated or being released from prison. When a child grows in the prisons, let's assume it's the case of a child born in prison. They grow up knowing prison is it. That's the environment. That's all they have known. Yeah. So when they come out to the outside world during reintegration, when they reach 4 years, or should the sentence of the mother come to an end before that, you know, they don't know the outside world. What they know is the life that is within the prisons. So they may find it difficult to adapt. But also something that can make the adapting difficult is the outside world would not be very friendly to the mother, because the mother is being seen as, you know, somebody who is stigmatized, somebody who was in prison, and the tag or the label of being a prisoner or a criminal may not easily leave the mother.
Naweza waambia tu pole, kama wajazoea kuona nje, kama wajazoea maisha mzuri. Siku moja tu atatubua kutoka hiyo prison.
I tell them to never lose hope, because the one thing about time is that it changes. And I'm one person who believes that with God you can go from grass to grace. I feel like the government should give the children a chance, ensure that everything they need is taken seriously, and the children feel comfortable despite their mothers being in prison.
I'm happy because I am because right now I'm going to school and I am free. I don't have but things are just fine here. For those children who are still in prison, I'd like them to be free, like they are.